In international news, Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe has announced that he was resigning from the post due to health concerns. The 65-year-old made the announcement at a press conference in Tokyo. Abe said that he needed to be treated for a flare-up of his intestinal disease that led his first one-year stint to end abruptly in 2007. He said he will receive new treatment but required prolonged care. The Prime Minister said he did not want his illness to get in the way of decision-making and apologized to the Japanese people for failing to complete his term in office. Earlier in the day, the Prime Minister and officials of the ruling Liberal Democratic Party held a meeting to discuss his decision to step down following his ill health, the country's national broadcaster NHK said in a report. Abe had been busy in recent months, working 147 days straight, dealing with the coronavirus pandemic and natural disasters that had hit parts of the country earlier this year. Israeli warplanes yesterday struck military facilities of the Islamic Hamas movement in Gaza in response to the firing of 6 projectiles into southern Israel. Hamas security sources told news agency that the Israeli warplanes targeted a training facility that belonged to Al-Qassam Brigades, the military wing of Hamas, south of Gaza City, with no injury or damage reported. A tit-for-tat escalation of tension has been going on in the Gaza Strip between Israel and Gaza militants since August 6th. Tension was started when unknown masked young men launched hundreds of incendiary balloons into Israel. In response, Israeli army warplanes and artillery have been attacking posts, sites, and military infrastructure of Hamas. Upping the ante against the center, hundreds of Delhi Congress workers staged a protest outside the Ministry of Education demanding postponing of NEET and JEE exams. Delhi Congress unit workers led by City Unit Chief Chaudhary Anil Kumar assembled near Shastri Bhavan, which houses the Education Ministry, and raised slogans against the Narendra Modi government. However, they were detained by the Delhi police and taken to Mandir Marg police station. Former Congress President Rahul Gandhi took to Twitter and wrote, "NEET JEE aspirants' safety should not be compromised due to the failures of the government. Government must listen to all stakeholders and arrive at a consensus." The Congress is protesting across the country demanding postponing of NEET JEE exams scheduled in the month of September amid coronavirus pandemic. Meanwhile, NSUI workers are sitting on a protest outside Shastri Bhavan for the last 3 days demanding postponing the examinations. Random testing for COVID-19 carried out by the Meghalaya government has yielded positive results, with several asymptomatic cases being detected due to antigen tests conducted mostly at marketplaces over the past few days. As of Friday, Meghalaya registered 75 new cases of COVID-19, including 33 during random sample surveillance exercise undertaken by the Health and Family Welfare Department, taking the active cases up to 1,222 and number of recoveries so far to 899, Director Health Services Dr. Amanwar said. Asked about the accuracy of the antigen test, especially the results of random sampling and testing, Dr. War said that any test cannot be stated as accurate. Meanwhile, after 6 months of total closure due to COVID-19 pandemic globally, the government of Meghalaya has decided to reopen Ward's Lake, Nehru Park and Elephant Falls from 1st of September 2020 for local tourism. This was informed by Minister of Arts and Culture A.L. Heck while talking to reporters. Nagaland RMSA Teachers Association 2016 batch has demanded that the state government immediately release pending salary without any delay so as to avoid any further legal complications. In this regard, the RMSA 2016 teachers questioned as to why the government and the department was not following the court's direction in releasing the salary of their teachers, whereas other batches of teachers under Samagra Shiksha have been paid. They said that sidelining a particular batch of teachers was total discrimination on the part of the government. President Ramnath Kovind virtually presented the prestigious Arjuna Award to Assam's boxer Lavlina Borgohain for her outstanding performance in boxing along with other athletes. The boxer won a gold medal at the first India Open International Boxing Tournament held in Delhi and a silver medal at the second India Open International Boxing Tournament held in Guwahati. She won a bronze medal at the 2019 AIBA Women's World Boxing Championship held at Ulan-Ude in Russia. With positive cases rising all across the nation, the COVID-19 status of northeastern states are: like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for all the latest news that matters and stories that inspire.